Mass 5, as I started off saying a few seconds ago, is Affymetrix' own algorithm, something that they did in house. And measurement of what Pues, ¿cuál es el otro tema que tenemos que noise. So, normalized distributions for data sets. Thank you. So, statistics. You pre-posted us a little comment. If you can get everything down that we link it, that's okay. I'll post my scripts and you have lots of time. We're going to be continuing to work on the analysis of this data set tomorrow. And my guess is that most of you at the end of it will come close to finishing everything that you discuss questions, but there'll be some aspects that you don't get to. And that's absolutely great. So let's talk about what you do after you've done the quality assessment of your data. The next thing that you do is you apply some statistical analysis. And as I mentioned this morning, there's basically many different types of statistical analysis that you can apply to microarray data, and we will focus almost exclusively on two sample tests. Simple for simplicity, and also because this is very applicable to a large fraction of microarray studies. Just as a reminder, generally, you can divide statistics into two broad branches, the area of significance testing and the area of estimation. If I say your centrality or measures of error, something like estimation, I say goodness of fit or a p-value. That's about significance testing. In some sense, what we've been talking about this morning has been all about estimation. It's about estimating the true signal. Now we're talking about what is the significance of it. We're going to talk about the types of ways in which we can identify interesting results. Very, very briefly, with the p-value. Thought of in the simplest way is investing. If I roll a 5 and you need a 6 to win, such a low win is 1 in 6, or a probability of you winning of 0.167. And immediately points out a couple of interesting things. P-values cannot be smaller than 0, p-values cannot be larger than 1, no negative numbers, no p-values of 0. P-value is generally thought to reflect the probability of one specific thing, although there can be joint p-values. values, and you can have complex definitions of what that thing is. Often people will say that p-value is less than some threshold to be interesting. If I said how small is the p-value I have to be before I what numbers come to mind? So, curiosity, where do those numbers come from? Does anybody know? Test makes an assumption about the underlying test. The cost of the test is a non-parametric test that Anybody want to add to that or change it? Imagine that I throw every Wednesday and I see how far I can throw. Then I get my cousin to throw a ball 5 times a day. I get my cousin to throw a ball 5 times today and see how far my cousin can throw. Error. So we made 5% more mistakes. it changes what you're comparing it to. False discovery rate is relative to your core deaths. Your p-value is relative to the entire population. That's why it's sometimes called a family-wise error rate. Last thing we'll talk about before going back to some more work is back to the probes that we mapped. And now with that context of noise and statistical analysis, we can talk about what is happening in the networks. Again, what we do is as arrays become outdated, the reference genome analysis is not necessarily a big deal. There are some clear changes, but if you're dealing with something like that, question four, five.